Flatliners comes to us from the director of The Swedish Girl with a Dragon Tattoo and the writer of Source Code. It's a remake, not sequel, of the 1990 film Flatliners. Both of these movies have Kiefer Sutherland in a role, different roles. This was marketed as a sequel. A lot of fans got excited about that. It's most certainly not. This is a reimagining, remake, whatever it is, it's not a sequel, that's for sure. And in this film, some medical students decide to flatline themselves and then resuscitate each other after a few minutes because they want to see if there's anything after death. And they find enlightenment as well as apparitions from their past who haunt them due to their guilt. And that's Flatliners. So this movie's really bad, and I saw it yesterday, and I decided, you know what, I could have just come home and just talked about how horrible it is and not really thought much about it, but I didn't. I took a day to think if there was a single redeeming thing that I could find amongst the mess that is this movie. And I really couldn't. The concept is good, but it's a concept that is from another film. It's a unique idea that could be interesting, and there could be some really cool things to discuss about medical students trying to figure out the afterlife and if there's any way to do that. But this movie takes what could be an interesting concept and turns it into a jump scare fest where you're really not sure what you're watching. This film is trying to be a medical thriller. It's trying to be a drama about guilt associated with past choices. And it's trying to be a jump scare horror movie as well. And it fails at all of them. It has some of the most unimaginably strange decisions from a writing standpoint, and this is one of the prime examples to show no matter how talented you are as a filmmaker, it really does come down to that script, the production, and the studio, and what exactly are they trying to make? What's the end product here? Because I love The Swedish Girl with the Dragon Tattoo. I think it's a fantastic movie. And the director of this movie, as well as the writer of Source Code coming together, this should have been really awesome. And Ellen Page is an extremely talented actress. And for whatever reason, what we have here is the epitome of a hodgepodge studio film where it, I wasn't there, so I don't know if this is true. But this feels, as I watched it, like 10 brains trying to make one movie, and all 10 brains had a different idea of what the film was supposed to be. And this is what we got. Flatliners is one of the most boring movies I have ever seen in my life. I struggled to maintain a desire to stay in the theater, but I watched the whole thing from beginning to end. It was me and some other guy in the theater, and he went on his phone a lot. And it was one of the few times this year where I wasn't annoyed by seeing some guy open up his phone and look at whatever he was looking at, because for whatever reason, the distraction of seeing his phone light up every once in a while was more entertaining than the film. Look, I don't like trashing movies. I really don't. I know how hard it is to make a film. It's really hard. I'm not trashing any one person here. This is an effort that just did not work out. And it's so clear that there wasn't enough communication between director, writer, studio, actors, because it feels like everyone's in a different movie. So clearly, I am not recommending that you see Flatliners. There are some things that occur in this movie that I really would love to talk about. It's going to involve some spoilers. If you wanted to see this film or care about spoilers, that's your warning. For everyone else, there are just some things I really need to talk about. So, the best part, and when I say the best, I mean the most, like, what part, is that after they flatline themselves, they sort of become enlightened. Ellen Page can all of a sudden play the piano beautifully. She answers every question in her class perfectly before the teacher even finishes asking the question. Another girl who flatlines herself is off in the corner solving a Rubik's Cube extremely fast. They basically straight up John Travolta in Phenomenon themselves. They all of a sudden have like this enlightened consciousness, and it's just so dumb. And that's one of the worst things about the film, is that it presents itself as really smart. All of these med students are giving off the most amazing medical jargon, and it's about people who kill themselves and resuscitate themselves and then start seeing ghosts and they can solve Rubik's Cubes perfectly. Some of the sound effect choices in this movie, also, I couldn't help but notice is awful. They're like 3,000 sounds on this disc.mp3 sound effects. There's a baby crying, where this guy's having this horrific vision. There's a baby locked in his boat somewhere, and it's like the same baby cry you've heard in everything since 1972. There's one jump scare sequence where someone's walking through a house and the radio starts playing "If You're Happy and You Know It, Clap Your Hands," because that's horrifying, I guess. Specific lines of dialogue as well when people are trying to find out what exactly is going on, because they're all seeing jump scare visions after flatlining, and somebody suggests that it might be supernatural, and one of the girls is like, "What, you mean like something demonic?" And then later in the film, when a character learns of the horror movie jump scare consequences of flatlining, she says to the character who did it before her, "Wait, you knew there was a downside to flatlining?" "Well, yeah, I mean, it's called dying. That's the downside to flatlining. Death." The biggest spoiler, though, and this is a major spoiler, is that Ellen Page's character dies halfway through this movie. Like, the lead actress, one of the only things that are going to get a lot of people to come see this movie, Ellen Page, dies halfway through. She was easily the most compelling character, and one of the only things in the movie that I felt remotely interested in watching, because she's so talented. She dies halfway through. For the rest of the movie, you're just stuck with these horrible horror movie cliche characters trying to figure out what exactly happens when they flatline. There are so many puns about this movie, flatlining at the box office and flatlining on Rotten Tomatoes, and it's deserved. Honestly, every single person involved with this movie seems to have dropped the ball entirely. It's one of the most boring films I've ever seen. I could barely get through it, but I did. I'm gonna give Flatliners an F. I waited 24 hours to review this movie because I actually wanted to see if there was something I could think about that was redeeming. I couldn't find it, guys. Just avoid this one like the plague. It's not worth your time or money. Thank you very much, as always, for watching. I also saw Gerald's Game on Netflix this weekend, as well as Battle of the Sexes, and I'll have reviews for those very soon, and the start of our Halloween special. It's going to be all through October. The first video in that special is going to be Gerald's Game, so look forward to that, guys. If you like this, you can click right here and get stuckmanized.